गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ PT2 सिलेबस, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 10, कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एंड नाउ इन 8th क्लास वी विल डिस्कस कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, द कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट कैन बी कैलकुलेट इन टू वेज. फर्स्ट, ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ सिंपल इंटरेस्ट फॉर्मूला. And second one is a compound interest formula. Okay, students. In compound interest, we are going to use the terms. The first one is principal. Principal is that amount which a person borrowed from the others. Okay. I repeat again, principal is that amount which a person borrowed from someone others for her personal use. Okay. Second one is rate. Rate is some percentage of that amount which a person have to pay as a interest when he returned the money to a particular person to whom he has taken the money. Okay. And then after time. Time is a duration, a period for which a person borrowed money from someone others. So since we can say ki what is the compound interest and how it calculates. So in compound interest, that's mean a money that a person have borrowed from someone else, but nobody will give you the money for a charity purpose. Everybody wants that whatever the money they are giving, they want some return in back of it. So the return, whatever a person is paying as a return extra than principal, so that is called the interest. And this interest, whenever it calculate annually means after 1 year we calculate this interest and plus in principal, and then again the interest calculated. I explain with this. For example, the first year interest one. Okay, so this interest one plus in principal, so here we will get P1. Okay, this is our P1 and we have calculated. For the next year, we are calculating again this interest over this one. So from here we will get the interest 2. So like this, students, every year we are calculating the interest and we are adding in a particular principal, and whatever the amount we are going to pay at the end of the year, that the extra amount whatever we are paying, that is our interest amount. Okay, so let's start. In this chapter, we are going to calculate the compound interest in two ways. So first exercise is based on simple interest formula. How we calculate on the basis of simple interest formula? So first of all, I'm going to write the formula for the simple interest. To find the simple interest, principal multiply rate percent and multiply the duration time and divide by 100. Okay, simple interest formula, students, we will find out the interest annually, and then after we add this interest in a principal, then we get the amount. How we get the amount? Amount equals to principal plus interest. Okay, how we get the amount? Principal plus interest. So in simple interest formula, first we find out the amount for the 1 year, then after again on for the next year, we will calculate the interest on this amount, and then we add to find the amount of the second year. So in this way, we will add again and again interest for the year, and we will at the end of the year, we will find that amount which a particular person have to pay as a return, and the extra amount, whatever he paid rather than principal, that is our compound interest. So to discuss and to understand this concept more clearly, let's start our exercise questions. And on the behalf of exercise, I'm going to explain some questions. So let's take its first question. Exercise 10.1. I'm going to write the key points of the question. In this question, they have given, students, Mrs. Sharma deposits 60,000 in bank for 2 years. So here the principal is, that is rupees 60,000. Okay. in a bank for 2 years. That's mean time duration T they have given 2 years. And if the interest is 8% per annum, so rate of interest, that is 8% per annum for 1 year, per annually or per annum, that's mean for the 1 year. You have to find out the compounded annually, interest compounded annually, what will be she receive at the end of 2 years. So students, we have to find out the amount that what she is going to receive after 2 years. So first of all, here we will find interest for the first year, and here we are using, so interest for first year. Formula we are going to use, principal into rate into time divide by 100. So here the principal is rupees 60,000. Okay, rate 8%, and student, here we are fine because we have to find the interest for the 2 year. But in compound interest, because we are using simple interest formula, so in compound interest we will find the rate, the interest for the one year. So first you found here the interest for the 1 year. So instead of time, I written, instead of 2, I written 1. So from here we get the interest. 20 cancel by 20, 64 ja 48, 4800. This is our interest for the 1 year. Okay, then after we will, after this one we will get principal for the second year. That's mean amount P1, this is our P1 plus interest for the first year. So 60,000 plus 48,000, we get 64,800. This is our principal for the second year. So in this way, students, we will get the principal for the second year, and again we will find out the interest. But to find the interest for the second year, find the interest for the second year, P2, that the principal for the second year multiply by rate and time is 1 year only. Okay, so here we will write 64,800 principal for the second year, then multiply by rate and this one 100 648, multiply by 8, then from here we will get, after multiply, 5184. This one is interest for second year. Okay, we will write interest for second year 5184. So since here we will find out the final principal compound interest. Compound interest equals to, because we have to find out the interest compounded annually. So to find the compound interest, interest for the first year plus interest for the second year. So interest for the first year is 4,800 plus interest for the second year 5,184. And when we add this one, the compound interest is 4, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, and 5 plus 4, 9. This is the interest amount that paid by the person after 2 years compounded annually, and the amount, the final amount paid by, the final amount Mrs. Sharma will get, that is amount principal plus CI. Principal is our 60,000 and compound interest is 9948. So 60,000 plus 9984, that the amount 69,984 Mrs. Sharma will receive after 2 years. So I want to explain this question, what we did in this question. Student, we have find out the amount that Mrs. Sharma will receive after 2 years by using compound interest. Means she will get compound interest on this amount. So here we are going to use to find the compound interest by simple interest method. In simple interest method, we will find out the interest one year. So first year we get the interest 4,800, that add in principal, then principal for the second year, and again we will calculate interest on this principal, and then after we get the final compound interest by interest for the first year and interest for the second year. When we add this both, the total compound interest is 9,984, and this amount plus in the first one 60,000, then we get this answer. Okay, so we find the compound interest and the amount that Mrs. Sharma received after 2 years by using simple interest method. But what we find here? Compound interest. Now let's discuss the question number second. Okay. Question number second. Mr. Nair deposit 1,40,000 in a chit fund company for 3 years. If the rate of interest is 14% compounded annually, how much interest will Mr. Nair receive at the end of 3 years? Means we have to find out how much interest he will receive. So same thing, I'm going to write the keywords of the question. Principal is rupees 1,40,000. Then after time, 3 year, and rate of interest, that is 14%. And we have to find out interest, that is compound interest, after 3 year. After 3 year. This thing we have to find out in this question. So since we have to solve this one by using simple interest method, so we will find the interest annually. For interest for the first year, 1,40,000 multiply by 14% rate, and because we are fine for the 1 year, so the this one 14 multiply by 14, we get from here 19,600 for the 1 year. Okay, then this was went here P1. Now P2 is P1 plus interest for the first year. So principal 1,40,000 plus 19,600. When we add this both, we get from here 1,59,600. This is our P2. Okay, now then after we have to find out interest for the second year. Here we will write P2 1,59,600, rate same 14%. Again for 1 year we are finding 20 cancel by 20. From here we will get for the interest for the second year after calculate this one. After calculation we get from here 22,344. Then from here we again get the P3, principal for the third year. How we get P2 plus interest for the second year? P2 is 1,59,600 plus 22,344. Now this addition is for the P3, principal for the third year, that is 1,62,344. Now again we will calculate interest for the third year. So 1,62,344 multiply by 14, and for again for the 1 year divide by 100. Okay, so from here we get student, the interest is, after solve this one, 22,000. When we multiply this one, 728.16. This is interest for third year. Now we have to find out the compound interest. Compound interest equals to interest for the 1 year plus interest for the second year plus interest for the third year. Interest for the first year is 19,600 plus for the second year 22,344. Then for the third year, student, दिस वन फॉर द थर्ड ईयर 22,728.16 एंड वेन वी डू द सम इज 64,672.16 रुपीज़ 16 पैसा. सो दिस मच द टोटल इंटरेस्ट दैट मिस्टर नायर रिसीव आफ्टर 3 ईयर. सो आई थिंक स्टूडेंट्स यू बेटर अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी हैव फाइंड दिस वन. वी फाइंड द इंटरेस्ट एनुअली आफ्टर वन ईयर, then add this interest into the principal, then again we calculate interest and then we get the final answer. Okay, so now we have done question number second. So let's discuss the question number third, that is also given the same type of the question. In question number third, they have given Surjit Singh brought 1,80,000 from the bank to buy a second hand car. If the rate of interest charge is 12% compounded annually, what amount will he pay at the end of 2 years? So keywords I am going to write from this one, that principal 1,80,000, rate of interest 12% and time duration 2 years. Okay, now we have to solve this question. First of all, interest for the 1 year, 1,80,000 multiply by simple interest method student we are using here. Okay, the compound interest method we will discuss in next exercise. From here we will get the interest for the 1 year. Then principal 2, that is principal for the 1 year plus interest for the 1 year, 1,80,000 plus 21,600. The addition we get from here, 2,01,600. This is our principal 2. After this one, we have to find out interest for the second year. 2,01,600 multiply by 12, then we find for the 1 year, and for interest for the second year we get from here 24,192. Now then after principal, the final amount he received, otherwise principal for the third year, that is 2,01,600 plus 24,192. The final amount is 2,25,792. That much amount, this much amount paid by Mr. Surjit after the end of 2 years. Okay, students. Now today we have discussed the first 3 questions of this exercise, student. Rest 3 questions you have to try by yourself as a homework. Okay, students. Thank you.